Yo, what's going on guys? TechGamer here and welcome back to another video. Today's video, I'm going to be taking apart this MacBook Pro. This is a 15-inch laptop. I'm not 100% sure what year it is, but it's old. I already kind of took it apart a bit, but it's kind of big. So this laptop's pretty old. In the description, I'll try to find out what year this laptop is, and I'll write it down there. But yeah, so without any further ado, let's get right into the video. So for the tools that I'm gonna be using in this video, I'm gonna use a couple of these screwdriver bits, pocket knife for taking, this is a Swiss Army knife for taking different like cables off. I might need to use some drills if there's gonna be some stuck screws. A small little screwdriver set with small screw Phillips head and flathead screwdrivers. And I'm also going to need a drill to drill out any screws that are really tightened up and I cannot remove. So that's what that's for. So that is pretty much all the tools that I'm going to be using in this video. So, yeah. So I already unscrewed part of the screws, and yeah. This laptop, I kind of abused it, but don't worry, this is not the reason why it died. I was just kind of testing out how strong the metal is on this, and it's quite strong. Yeah, so don't mind that. And I already undid the screws. They're basically all the screws you need are on the sides. And I think that's all from the, so that's this side of it. You can see our trackpad right here. So we have our little trackpad right here. Keyboard. So right here we can see our little circuit board for the trackpad right here. We can see our keyboard, grills for our speakers right here. I don't think this is a speaker. I'm not 100% sure what that is. A couple different circuits here. But this is not all where all the interesting stuff is. So this is inside the laptop. Oh yeah, also, I already took this out, but there was a battery right here. So if I put this over on this side, there's a battery right here. Let me put that in, just show you how to take it out if I can. Let's see. Why can I not take it to put this in? Oh, right, I need this stuff down. Yeah, so it was in here, basically. I can't put it in today. That's weird. Okay. Oh. Yeah, so you put it in like this, and kind of go like that to take it out. Just pull on these things and it pops out. And also, right here, you'll also find the RAM. This is the RAM it came with. It's 2 gigabytes. Let's see if that focuses. 2 gigabytes of DDR2 at 667 megahertz. Yeah, this stuff is slow right now, but back in the day, this was pretty fast. And there's 4 gigs. So that's actually really good for a laptop of this age. Yeah, so that was right here. Let's see, I think it was like right here. So it was like this. Only 2 sticks that goes in here. It's pretty good. So this is probably something you can salvage and maybe sell on eBay or something. I don't know how much this will sell for, but yeah, in this video, I'm also gonna show you guys what kind of parts you can possibly salvage from a broken laptop. I can't. Since I kind of took apart, it's kind of, okay, there you go. There's a bunch of metal shavings here because I think I just cut myself. Let's get that out of the way. Okay, so this is the interior of the laptop. Right here, we have our DVD drive right here. I think that's the first part I can remove real quick. I already undid all the screws for this. So that's a DVD drive there, and connects with this kind of connector with this. So it goes all right here. We see our battery right here for the BIOS. And yeah, so we can, this is also something that you can possibly sell or reuse on other laptops, maybe possibly. Yeah, so all right, so we removed the DVD drive, and now I'm gonna remove this hard drive right here. See if I can maybe zoom in a bit on the hard drive. Oh wait, is that the maximum? Oh, that's the maximum. All right. Okay. Yeah, sorry for my voice a bit. I'm a bit sick right now. Yeah. So this is the hard drive right here. Looks like it's 200 gigabyte hard drive. Let's remove these cables. I don't know if there's a good way to remove these. Yeah. So maybe this is a good part where the Swiss Army knife comes in. So I have a little pliers right here. I can grip onto this little plastic part and rip it out. I'm not sure if there's like a good, better way to remove these. Why is this not coming out? I feel like I'm gonna just rip this out. I mean, I don't really care because this laptop's already broken. Yeah, so we can remove this cable here. Yeah, looks like I already did. Yeah, so I think there was a bracket holding this down. So again, I'm sorry that this is not a complete teardown, but at least this shows you how to get to the parts, kind of, and where everything is located. So this is the hard drive right here. This is a small hard drive. I'm probably gonna reuse this and see if I can use this in my computer for some extra storage, because this is 200 gigabytes, and that's a really good storage. And it has the SATA connectors, so you can use this in any modern computer, which is really good. Yeah, so that is the hard drive out of the way. Right now, I think I can pull out this Wi-Fi card. That's probably the next thing I'm gonna do. And why can I not zoom in more on this? That's weird. Kind of move it a bit. Okay. Let's see if I can. Yeah, I don't think I can zoom in. Okay. I'm recording on my webcam. Where's my screwdriver? Ah. Okay. Yeah, I don't have any good tools to remove these kind of screws. We can. There you go. So that screw right there, one of those little star-shaped ones. I don't have any of those kind of screwdrivers, so I'm just gonna use, where is it? I'm gonna use this screwdriver. It's gonna focus. Come on. A little bit. There you go. So just a Phillips head screwdriver. It's one of these. So, I mean, it works. I can get some grip on it and kind of remove it. And if we can't remove it, that's what this thing's for right here. I can always use a power tool to remove. And this is also a good part to use some pliers to remove these cables without damaging them. So just try to gently remove this. If you're actually trying to repair this, try to be gentle. So you can remove these cables right here. This thing comes out, and out comes the Wi-Fi card. I believe this thing has Bluetooth, like, I think this is a Bluetooth and Wi-Fi card. I might be wrong. I haven't used this laptop in a very long time. Why is this not focusing for me? There you go. Yeah, so that is the Wi-Fi card. And here, maybe, I think I have, yeah. So this is from a Mac. There's also Wi-Fi cards like this. This is from a Windows laptop. Yeah, there are different sizes. And the pin layout is also different. For these ones, it's the same pin layout. If you can focus a bit, come on, camera.
gonna focus sometimes if I do this? Come on. Yeah, but, oh, there you go. Yeah, so see, the pin layout on these are the same. There are Wi-Fi cards with different pin layouts, but I'm not sure if they're compatible with both. I'm pretty sure they're not. Yeah, so right now, because we removed a lot of the stuff in the front, like this CD drive and the hard drive, this laptop's kind of like a seesaw. All the weight is back here, because this part is basically empty. There's nothing there, just a frame. So, let's see what we can remove next. We can unplug some of these wires, and maybe this thing right here. See, we can kind of move most of these wires. See if I can remove this speaker thing out. And there's a wire down there that needs to be removed. And all right, looks like it does go underneath the screen. I think I can just tear out this wire. And that goes to the screen. This wire too. There we go. And let's see, where does this wire go? Where does this wire go? I don't know where this wire goes. Okay, I can just remove this part. Yeah, so maybe I can see. Yeah, this is the speaker right here. And I'm trying to figure out where this wire goes. Looks like it goes to the underside of this motherboard. So I guess we'll leave that on for now. Maybe if I remove the fan. Yeah, let's do that. We can remove the fan. And the fan is probably also a piece that you can salvage. Maybe you can use it for some kind of project or something. I don't know. There's a couple screws. There's this one, that one. Okay, and the fan should pop out. Just unplug this wire here. And there we go. It's a bit dusty.
Here it is. It's a DC brushless, and looks like it's 5 volts. Yeah, at 0.29 amps. So, yeah, it's a nice little fan. The bearings look nice. Yeah, so there's two of these guys.
In here, and it's, yeah. So, I still don't have access to that. But here's the heatsink. It is dirty, yeah. So, that's where the fan is. Fans get dirty in laptops. Something you should probably clean maybe twice a year. I'd recommend that. And while we're at the fans, let's just remove the second one right here. You don't see it. There we go. Remove this fan. It out.
Okay, don't know where that screw went. Oh, there it is. Yeah, so just unplug it. Here's the second one.
Same thing. Same fan.
There we go.
Also, that's how the place looks like where the fan was. It's
also really dusty. And basically, now we just need to remove the motherboard. All right, so now we need to remove the motherboard from this computer. And yeah, so we can just unplug all the cables coming out from the motherboard.
So we can do this cable right here. There's
another one right here. We can just pull it out, comes out. Another one right here. Some of these can be hard to take out, like this one right here. But it's a lot easier to do it with like some pliers. Definitely. Yeah, there's one right here. And wait, is this, could this be, no, I don't think it is. This is the right, the same cable. Okay, yeah, and I also want to take this as an opportunity to show how to remove a screw if it's, jammed inside. So, oh shoot. So, I had to do that this once already, or maybe twice, or a couple of screws I want coming out. So basically, we have this screw right here, and let's just say the screw is stuck, and you don't have the right tools to take it out. Maybe you have only like a small screwdriver like this, and it's just not grabbing it, and you have a drill, and with a drill, you can quite easily drill this thing out. So let me try to, and also let me just put, let's say, like a hard drive right here just for more counterweight, because this thing's like a seesaw right now. Here, let's see if I can. So I think this is a good shot. Hopefully I'm not gonna drill into the camera. Basically, take your drill, make sure it's spinning the right direction, just run it once, and looks like mine is. And put it right in the center of that screw. And if you look at the size of my drill bit to the screw, it's basically the same size. So what you want to do is just apply a lot of pressure onto your drill and just run it full speed. And eventually it'll basically drill away the screw. But make sure to, if you actually want to remove this, just remember, when you drill this away, you're not going to be able to use this screw again. And if you want to reuse the motherboard, make sure to stop as soon as you hear the pop when the cap of the screw comes off. Let me see if I can show you how the screw looks like. Here, oh yeah. Basically, you have this cap. That's basically the part you want to drill away. Okay, so let's start drilling. Boom. The second you hear the pop, just stop. Now I might have broken some little parts, but hopefully not. So that is, let's see, will it focus? Focus! Come on. Is it gonna focus? I don't know, the camera's not focusing for me. Let's see if I can. Okay, that's a bit better. Yeah, so I drilled it away. You see there's no more screw. The screw's gone. And it looks like everything around is fine. There's just a bit of shavings. Now before you, if you put this back and want to use it again, make sure to clean away all those iron shavings, because if you don't clean them away and you run the computer, it can cause a short. And want focus on. Yeah, you can short the computer out if you don't clean away those shavings, because if those shavings land in between one of these little connections, it'll short out the motherboard, and that's not good. You don't want that. Oh, and also, you can see from the tip of my bit, we have this little thing that came out. And I guess it could be like a DIY washer, because it's basically a washer. You can use this as a washer right here. And I actually have every single time you can make these. It's actually really cool. If you don't have washers, you can make them by just drilling a screw. So that's a little life hack. Yeah, so yeah. And hopefully now, and I forgot to take out this wire right here. There you go. It looks like the motherboard is coming out. I might have forgotten some kind of screw. I don't know. Okay, so let's just try to lift this away.
And then always just look underneath to make sure nothing is attached. I don't know what's in the way. There's something. Maybe. Let's just try. This wire is like.
Is it screwed on? Oh, okay, I see ya. This wire is screwed on. See, we might have to drill this one out too. Nope, this one comes out. Some of these screws, they just come out really easily. For some, you just need like a small little push with some pliers and they come out. So it all depends. Okay, maybe now should come out. Let's see. Oh, there is a little power connection, but here, I want to try to remove this part first. I wonder if there's. It looks like the heatsink just comes right off. Oh, okay, yeah. This wire is glued on, like taped on. There we go. Now, we can just wiggle this out. Oh, it's just this VGA cable is in the way. I mean, connector. Oh, no, it's DVI. Sorry. Ah, why is this not coming out? Yeah, I can maybe try to bend this plastic and this casing away, and geez. Yeah, this thing really requires a lot of force. Ah, there you go. Okay. Okay, so we have the motherboard finally out of this. And we can remove this power cable. This is the main power to the motherboard, most likely. And so this is the boring side right here. Nothing very interesting here, but basically just the board right here. I have the spot for the speaker. I thought at first that the speaker was like built into the motherboard, but nope, it's right here, right there. Now, looking at the interesting side of the board, right here. And this side, I guess, a bit more interesting. Here, let's just remove this. Don't know what that's doing there. Here, you can see all the good stuff. Okay, let's see how close I can get. Yeah, I'm using my webcam, the Logitech C920, so hopefully it... Hopefully this quality is good of the video. Yeah, so this right here, let's see what this is. I'm gonna say that this is a CPU. Bit dusty right there. It says Intel APU. Okay, I think this is the graphics, I think. Let's see. I don't really know which one is what. Now these Apple doesn't really like to say what their specs are. This thermal paste just crumbling off. I'm just gonna assume that this is the CPU and these might be like the GPUs. Probably. It's interesting that there's three. And yeah, that's interesting. Yeah. And this is the I/O right here. We have a VGA. That is something very, it's not focusing. VGA, you don't find these a lot on laptops. And yeah, so VGA. And we have an internet port right there. Autofocus is being really weird today. Okay, and looks like we have, don't remember what this wire is. If any of you guys know what this port is, please tell me in the comments below. Then we have, what is this?
I should know this. FireWire? I'm gonna say it's FireWire. I might be wrong. Yeah, I might be wrong about this one. This is USB. That's obvious.
Yeah, so not a lot of I/O on this part. There's more on the other part of the motherboard here, but I wanna, let's just set this aside, where we're not gonna break it. Okay. And let's see, maybe, no, let's see if I can remove the cooling. There you go, yeah. And this also brings us to why Apple products overheat so much. If you just look how thin these heat pipes are, and this is cooling three components that produce heat, because there's thermal paste on all of those. So there's like CPU and like GPU. I'm assuming that both of these are GPU. I'm not 100% sure. This is most likely CPU. This is probably GPU. Don't know what that is, but probably also GPU. So three components that produce a lot of heat. And we have two very tiny heat sinks. These are very small. Very small. And another one on this one. They're very small. And we have just two heat pipes that are extremely thin. And that is why Apple products overheat. And also, if you look right here, where the fans are, on focus, let's see, focus, yeah, right here, there's no vents. Basically, what the laptop is relying on, like, I don't even know where the air comes in for the fans. Like, maybe through here, but that's like the exhaust. So the intake for the air is also really bad. And I'm not saying that I don't like Apple. Apple's really good, but their thermals on their laptops are kind of high. I mean, I don't know about their newer laptops, but at least I remember on this one, it was really hot. Like, I can barely hold it on my lap. Well, just to show like a comparison, this is a heatsink from a Windows computer. And this is only a CPU, so there's no dedicated graphics, just a CPU, i5 4200M processor at 2.5 gigahertz. It's a two-core, four-thread processor. And just comparing this, like, the heatsink is twice as big. The heat pipe is bigger. And there's just more surface area on this one. So, I mean, it's not that big of a difference, but still. Just, yeah. It's a very small heatsink for Apple. And I'm not saying that I hate Apple. No, Apple is great. Just kind of overpriced. Okay, so let's figure out how to remove this wire. I'm guessing these are like thermal sensors, because I saw someone right here. This wire right here, I'm assuming that this is some kind of thermal sensor. Because why else would it be attached on the heat sink, on the pipe thing? So, there you go. Yeah, there's like little clips here. Oh, this is the speaker. Yeah, that's the speaker wire. Okay, that makes more sense. Let's see if I can remove this. Nope, let's just drill this out. I don't think this will take long. Oh yeah, okay, I went too far. Whatever. It's not like there's anything important there.
Yeah, that's a speaker. Kind of over-drilled right here, but it's fine. It's fine. I'm not gonna use this. But maybe if you want, you can salvage this. You have some speakers, you can, I don't know, make some kind of portable speaker device with this, possibly. I don't know. I mean, these speakers are trash. They're not good. I mean, some laptops have good speakers. This one, not so much. Let's just remove this wire right here. This is the power. This comes to our battery. Right here. Let's hope that these wires will be nice to us. If
If not, I guess I'm gonna have to pop out my drill.
Yeah.
Although I don't really need to remove these, but. Yeah, whatever. These are kind of. I guess, whatever. We'll just remove them. Yeah, these screws are a bit thicker. Yeah. That's gonna take so much time. Yeah. Anyway, I don't really need to get this out. So, let's just remove this here. Also,
what you can do, you can... Oh, didn't notice that I was kind of outside of my
film shot. You can take your screwdriver and just clip on your Phillips head, I mean your pliers, and kind of twist, and if you're lucky, in this case, I don't think I am, you should be able to twist this screw out. In this case, I'm not, so we can just pop open our drill.
I really am. It's probably all out of focus. So let's just remove this
right here. And we can use these little pliers to remove the tape. Take your Phillips, finally. It's the first Phillips. Oh, shoot. It's the first Phillips screw that I saw in here.
And it comes out.
Awesome. One more here. Let's hope this one's also good. Eh. These. Yeah, finally.
It got it. Now I got this screw right here. Oh, dropped it. Got this one right here. And this one comes out well.
And the next thing you know, do we need this bracket? Please tell me we needed this. I don't know.
This thing came out. Don't know what that is. It's something. It's definitely something.
Maybe. I don't know why this thing's not coming out. Like this. I feel like I might be missing something obvious here. Let's see. I don't know. I actually don't know what's up. That's interesting. It's like it doesn't want me. It's like it doesn't want me to take it out. I mean, this screws out. Maybe something is holding it on the backside. Let's see. Doesn't look like it. Oh, look, there's a spring. We got a spring, guys. This laptop has a spring.
Look at that. Don't remember where it came from, though. But maybe you can salvage this, too.
Yeah, let's see.
Basically, I'm trying to get this part of the motherboard out with all the extra I.O. And I don't seem to know where... There is another screw to take it out from. Which is interesting. Because there should be a screw. Is it just not budging anywhere? That's interesting. I mean, it's kind of budging. I mean, if I lift hard enough on this thing, yeah. I don't know. I feel like I'm gonna damage this. I mean, something's lifting. What if I just pry it open? It's lifting. Oh, I think I got it. Pinch myself there. Okay. Maybe we'll find out what is in the way. Oh, okay. So we got it out.
Ah.
This thing was holding it. This screw right there, that was the culprit.
Yeah. So,
this is the rest of the I.O. right here. Let me put it here.
It's like,
because this, the charging port is all magnetic. There's a bunch of metal parts that are getting attached to it. And why is it not focusing? Focus! Focus! Come on! Yeah, I don't know what's up with this. Come on. Focus.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't know what's up.
So this is the microphone and the headphone.
Or speaker thing. USB charger. And I don't know what's up with the camera. It's not focusing. Yeah, it's not doing it. Yeah, so now right here, I don't know what this thing's for. But you can put something inside.
You can put something inside. That's for sure. And then kind of plastic covering. Maybe it means that we're not supposed to go under it, but I'm gonna try to open it. There's some more screws on this side too. But you know what? I'm sick of screws right now. Where's my knife? Let's just switch over to scissor mode. Scissor mode. And let's cut this. Yeah. There you go. Probably damaged half the components underneath. Let's see what kind of treasure lies underneath this. There better be something cool. So this, Apple's trying to hide this with some black plastic. And doesn't look like there's anything interesting. Looks like it's just protective plastic.
So there you go. That's the underside of this thing.
It's pretty interesting. And that kind of wraps up the... It's a bunch of tape everywhere. So that basically wraps up the teardown of this laptop.
And there is a lot of dust right here.
That's kind of disgusting. That's really disgusting. Yeah, so that is basically what's inside. I'm not going to go into the screen because, I mean, it's just a screen. There's nothing really fancy about the screen.
I mean, there's a camera, but, I mean, that's a potato camera right there. Don't want to open it.
Let's see. Yeah, that's basically it from inside. Let's just take this out. That's something you can salvage. Don't throw away the hard drives. So we can toss this aside, stand, so I can show you guys what I was able to salvage out of this laptop. Let me zoom out a bit, just have a bigger angle. So got a couple cables. We don't really need that stuff. Got thermal paste everywhere. I'm gonna have to clean this up after shoot. Ah, too much trash. Got a hard drive.
Keep it. Do not throw away.
You can use this. I mean, unless it's broken, but this thing's probably usable. We got fan number one. We got fan number two. We got 4 gigs of RAM. You can keep it. You can use it in maybe another computer, but not a lot of computers use DDR2. But if it's DDR3, I probably recommend you guys to keep it. Because computers still use DDR3. A lot of them do. We got the heat sink. The sad excuse of a heat sink. Because these things are not going to be able to cool your internals well. We got speaker number one. And speaker number two right here. Two speakers. You can salvage this stuff.
Motherboard.
I mean, this one, it's probably broken because something broke on this laptop. I'm going to assume it's the motherboard because the motherboard normally breaks down. If you know that your motherboard is working, you can sell it.
You can probably sell this for, I don't know, $20.
Probably not much. I mean, this thing does have a CPU, GPU, so Maybe more. I'm not 100% sure on this. But yeah, this one, because when I was taking it apart right here, there used to be one of these connectors, but I accidentally tore it off. So this one, if you do something like that to it, you're not going to be able to sell it. No. We got a battery. I mean, you could salvage this, but I don't see why. But so I wouldn't personally salvage that. DVD drive. You can actually, instead of DVD drives, you can take out some pretty cool parts. There's some motors in here. There's some lasers. So you can probably make something out of this. Let's see if I'm missing something. I mean, there's this part, but I don't see anything useful out of this. I mean, maybe you can, I mean, if you are into collecting different computer parts, you can probably take, unsolder these like USB ports and audio ports and different things like that. You can unsolder things from this. Let's see, there are some springs in laptops apparently. You can use that. Yeah, so these are kind of the, I'd say, the most salvageable components that I was able to pull out of the laptop. I'm just trying to see if there's anything else lying around on my table, and I don't think so. Oh, yeah. So, I mean, also this thing. I didn't notice I was out of the camera view. But yeah, that is basically what's inside of a laptop. And unfortunately for Apple products, you can't really take out these CPU like you can on some other laptops. There's a i5 CPU that I was talking about earlier. It's the i5 4200M CPU. And this is from a laptop, so you can take it out. It's just, for size comparison, it's basically the same size. Yeah. And this is from a desktop. Another CPU, also similar size. So I just don't understand why they couldn't. I mean, I guess it's for, maybe they're trying to conserve some space in here. Yeah, here's another CPU. Yeah, they're basically the same size. I mean, if you take off this heatsink that I did on this one, they could have fit a CPU easily inside here. So, I mean, yeah. Unfortunately, can't take out the CPU and like use it for something else. Yeah, that is basically everything inside of this laptop. And I'm gonna probably finish the video here because there's nothing else to take apart from this laptop. And if you like this video, please give this video a thumbs up. Maybe let's try 20 likes. I feel like this video will get a lot of views because my gaming PC build got like almost 900 views and 27 likes, I think. And I feel like this video can also do good. So 20 likes? That, I don't know, does that seem reasonable? I think so. Yeah, so let's try to get 20 likes. That'll be awesome. Subscribe on my channel if you haven't already. That would really be awesome. And yeah, so I hope you guys enjoy this teardown of this Apple MacBook Pro. I'll try to find out what year this is from and the specs in here. I know that there's 4 gigs of RAM. That's basically the only thing I know from this computer. But yeah, so that's basically it for this video, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.